live for the first worship experience of 2018. Get some of your folks to watch it. Doesn't matter if they're heterosexual, if they're transgender, if they're gay, if they're lesbian, if they're bisexual. We just want them to experience God, right?
Amen.
And so somebody, get somebody to join you on Facebook. Behold, I will do a new thing.
Yes.
Now,
yes.
It shall spring forth.
Yes.
Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert.
Well.
I want to tag this text with the theme, springing in the new.
Amen.
springing in the new. Somebody's going to get that in a minute. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. As we think about the old becoming new, I want to let you know it is possible on today. Many of us have old clothes in our homes. We have old furniture in our home. I guess y'all don't have none. Y'all ain't saying nothing. We have old jewelry in our homes. We have old clocks in our homes. Oftentimes, all the old things need is a makeover. Anybody ever took some old pants and decided to do something new with them? When you did, they thus became new. Anybody ever taken some old furniture and had upholstery done to it? Amen. When you did, it thus became new. Anybody ever decided to take some old jewelry? Y'all don't have the old jewelry here, but somebody might have a friend that's got some old jewelry and make it into something else. When you did, it thus became new. We've seen the TV shows on HGTV and DIY. Property Brothers, Fixer Upper, Rehab Attic, Flip and Lock, where they take old houses, make them over again, and they thus become brand new. Now they have a show called Flea Market Flip, where persons take old products, repurpose them, make a brand new item, and thus sell it to somebody else. Church, there's something about taking the old and doing something new with them that makes all the difference in the world. Oftentimes, the old is not unusable. It just needs a little love. It just needs some vision. It just needs a special touch. It just needs something greater to transform it into what it can be. I believe that is what God does with us, church. God knows we have gifts. God knows we have talent. God knows we have abilities that we're not using at the moment. And he touches us, shows us his vision, transforms us, and thus causes us to become brand new. Do I have any witnesses of today? There was a song that used to bless my spirit many years ago. The songwriter simply says, you know my other side. He says, I can no longer hide. Let you down so many times. Sin freshly crucified. Thought I had a plan. I had it all figured out. But the more that you tried to be by my side, the more I pushed you out. He goes on in the chorus and says, Lord, make me over. Lord, make me over. Lord, make me over. Make me over again. Make me over again. Somebody's heard that before. So the question becomes, are you ready for the new thing that God is about to do? Are you ready for the new thing that God is about to do? When we look at new, it's sometimes hard to get ourselves ready. We become accustomed to things being a certain way. We get used to doing things the same way. We get comfortable with things being the way that they are. However, God in God's wisdom sometimes needs to change things. And God tells us God is going to do a new thing. When God does, we have to prepare ourselves. And so I want to suggest to you today a few things to do that will help you prepare for the new thing or the fulfillment of things that are about to come in your life. You must have one, expectation. You must, two, walk in the now. And three, understand springing forth. One, expectation. I know y'all are making mental notes here. Two, walk in the now. And three, understand springing forth. Anyone who's ever heard me preach at any point in my preaching years, which is almost about 18, at some point has heard me talk about expectation. Yes. I believe expectation is at the core of our faith. It is at the core of our belief. For us to have never seen God, never personally, physically touched God, there is something at the core of our faith and belief that makes us continue to trust in God and call upon God's name each day. There is something that makes us know that God is God and that God will do exactly what he said he will do. There is something that makes us believe that when we offer a prayer to God to heal our bodies, God will do just that. Church, I like to call that something expectation. We ought to walk in expectation each day, each hour, each minute of God doing exactly what God has promised to do in our lives. The Bible says, listen carefully, I'm about to do a new thing.
Yes.
Here, church, the prophet Isaiah is telling the people, don't just believe God because all that he has already done for you, but believe that God is able to surpass everything God has already done. The prophet Isaiah is giving the people the message here that God can still be trusted to direct the future of God's people. So know that whatever God has already done, church, God can surpass and do greater. Somebody needs to receive that today. God can surpass and do greater. God can do greater in your life is what I'm telling you at this point. Here at ELC in 2016, God gave me the word that greater is coming. Somebody remembers that because we said that on Sundays. And then in 2017, God gave me the word that greater is here. We said that in the service. And then I know that God gave me for 2018 that this is the year of fulfillment. And so we'll be saying that in 2018. So whatever God has already done, know that God can exceed that, and everything he promised you shall be fulfilled. Fulfillment now, somebody's not getting it. Fulfillment meaning to bring to reality, to bring to completion, to cause to realize or to carry out. Church, God said he's going to fulfill some great things for us in 2018. So all I came to tell you today is get ready, get ready, get ready, and walk in expectation for God to complete it at any moment. When we walk in expectation, we must make sure our expectation is not minimized. Don't be afraid to expect God to do great things for you. A story is told about the fathers of the city of New York as they contemplated the future growth of the city. They laid out the streets and numbered them from the center outward. When they began, there were only 6 or 7 streets that they considered. In their planning maps, they projected how large they thought the city might grow to the city of New York. And reaching beyond their wildest imagination, they drew streets on the map all the way out to 19th Street. They said, we feel New York is going to get all the way to 19th Street in its biggest day. So they called that street Boundary Street because they were sure that at its largest, New York City would only be 19 streets. But history has proven them to be short-sighted. At the last count, the city had reached at least 284 streets, far exceeding their expectations. So we are taking our expectations to the limit, church. We are believing God for bigger and better. We are trusting God for what God has the power to do and nothing less. Don't shortchange God, church, because God won't shortchange you. I came to tell you, walk in high expectation on today and believe that God has the power to do it and do it in your life. Once again, you must, one, have expectation, two, walk in the now, and three, understand springing forth. Now, if you could step up in the area of expectation and walk in high expectancy each and every day, then I believe you will be just where the prophet Isaiah wanted the people to be here in the text. The Bible says, I'm about to do a new thing now.
Well,
somebody ought to get excited about the word now. Because no matter how you look at it or when you look at it, now means at this very moment. Now means at this present time. Somebody can experience that now moment before I get through with this message. Somebody missed their shout right now. Somebody can experience that now moment before we leave this worship service. Somebody can experience that now moment before the day ends and before 11:59:59 occurs. If you're going to believe in the new thing that God is doing, you need to understand it to show up at any moment now. Any moment now, any moment now, any moment now. You're you. You can be sitting in the pews at this church, and all of a sudden, your blessing overtakes you. Somebody got to get ready to call now. The now, the now, the now that's coming in your life. Because with the now, God is not going to wait any longer. I don't believe you need to wait any longer. Some of us have asked God for things and we haven't gotten ready yet. Some of us have been wasting time going around in circles and shooting the breeze, as the old people used to call it. I came to tell somebody your playtime is over. Stop wasting your time and stop wasting God's time. Prepare yourself for the next level and know that God is ready. The prophet Isaiah here is informing the people that the new thing that God is doing is going to involve transformation. This transformation will lead to the blessing. The prophet here envisioned something that is totally different from what is before him at that moment. But he could see what God was going to do and was trying to prepare the people for the point, that point when it arrives in their lives. I believe God is going to do some spiritual things in this house. God is going to do some physical things in this house. God is going to do some powerful things with these people. There's going to be a transformation like we've never seen before. And so we must ready ourselves for the new that is coming now in ELC. We must ready ourselves for the new that's coming now in our personal lives. We must ready ourselves for the new that's coming now in our personal relationships. Springing forth. If you're able to walk in expectation each day and know that your blessing can overtake you at any time now, then I believe you'll understand how God is going to do it. Church, the Bible tells us that God's thoughts are not our thoughts and God's ways are not our ways, because the heavens are higher than the earth. So are my ways higher than yours and thoughts than yours. So this lets us know we will never quite understand how God is going to do it, but we have the assurance that God will do it. We don't know how our healing will come. We just know that the healing is coming. We don't know how our financial breakthrough is going to come. We just know that the breakthrough is coming. We don't know how our change is going to come. We just know that change is coming. So we have to trust. We have to believe. We got to expect. And know that if God says it, then that settles it. So I came to tell somebody today that God says, one more time, I'm about to do a new thing. Now it will spring forth. It's about to spring forth. Church is about to spring forth. As we look at a spring on what it does, to spring means to move suddenly. It rapidly takes you upward. It moves you to a higher place. It doesn't give you time to think and negotiate. Y'all know how we always need to negotiate. Before you know it, you're already there. Somebody needs to know why you're trying to negotiate with God. You are already going to be there on your next level. Into their joy. Thank God for the spring effect that's going to thrust somebody into the constricted from a place that looks to be dry and no life can come forth from it. He understands that God constricted from a place that looks dead, looks like there's no life in it. All I know is that when the enemy looks around, honey, you're already in your next level. When the enemy looks around, you're going to already have your new job. When the enemy looks around, you'll be in your new loving relationship. When the enemy looks around, you're going to already have your feet put on in your new house. You're going to have your money coming from your new business. You're going to have more clients than you've ever seen before. You're going to have a fresh anointing. You'll have your education. You'll be serving in the church, doing what God has called you to do. Thank God for the spring that is driving us into the new thing that God is doing. The spring of that church will take you into fulfillment. God's about to fulfill everything that he promised. God's about to fulfill every prophetic word.